Health officials are fighting to contain a norovirus outbreak that is continuing its spread on the Lower Mainland. The outbreak has hit 5 local hospitals, along with daycare facilities and the general public. Lisa Johnson has more on the highly contagious outbreak.
To give you a sense of just how infectious norovirus is, meet Vomiting Larry, a robot created by British scientists to study how the virus spreads itself by making victims throw up. One droplet of infected fluid has enough virus to make thousands sick. On top of that, a new strain is circulating this year that first emerged in Sydney, Australia last March, and our immune systems haven't built up defenses to it yet. So it's no wonder BC health officials are fighting to contain norovirus. There are outbreaks now at Vancouver General Hospital, at Royal Columbian in New Westminster, Eagle Ridge in Port Moody, Burnaby Hospital, and among the general public. From a safe distance, by phone...
Oh, hi, is this Carrie?
I spoke to a Vancouver mom who's been vomiting for 15 hours and is unable to eat.
I don't think I've ever vomited so bad in my whole life. I couldn't even hold down water. It's just been horrible.
Carrie Sandrin's teenage son had it first, and she got it despite her efforts to sanitize the home.
You know, I didn't let him come into the kitchen, and I was just so cautious about it, but obviously not cautious enough.
Norovirus sometimes gets called the stomach flu, but bear in mind, it is not influenza, so the seasonal flu shot won't protect you. If you do get the norovirus stomach bug, then health officials ask you not to go to hospital or your doctor's office, but to stay hydrated and stay home.
People feel that they're helping by soldering on when they're unwell, but if they're infectious, what they're doing is increasing the risk to the workplace, to the risk to the hospital, and we really do encourage people to stay home, particularly with these very infectious diseases that are circulating.
And even after someone stops feeling sick, they may still be contagious for 72 hours. Lisa Johnson, CBC News, Vancouver.